National Federation of the Blind. Live the life you want through science, technology, engineering, and math.
Hello, my name is Mark Barlow. I'm the industrial arts instructor at BLIND Incorporated in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Mark shows us the basics of using the click rule.
What we have here is a beautiful half-inch thick piece of pine. And what I'm going to do is just show you the setup of that. And it's very important that, what the goal here is we're going to measure this narrower dimension of that board. We're going to make a measurement in the narrow dimension. Any three-dimensional object in our world has a height and a width and a depth. And generally, those dimensions are listed as height by H by W by D. Generally, if there is an identifiable front to a given object. So this is a chunk of wood. It really has no front or back or side. It does have two faces and two edges and two ends based on the anatomy of a given chunk of wood. What I'm going to do, because this is narrow in this direction, I'm going to set my click rule with the fence of the click rule flush to the edge, nice and parallel to the edge, making full contact in the long direction. The maker of the click rule gave us that beautiful flat edge, that flat side of the information rod that allows us to place that rod beautifully flat on the surface of whatever we're measuring. And then what we do is we take the end of the information rod and run it parallel to the edge of the wood. And we have a lovely example here. This is great. What I'm going to do is get that information rod as parallel as I can, which I just did, and I ask my students to tighten the knob so that measurement is not going to shift. It's not going to slip. And then I ask students to pick this to pick the click rule up off of the object that you're measuring so that you disregard this and focus on the task at hand, which is to count your measurement. And so from the bottom, it is 0, half, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, and some mystery clicks. And that means what I'm going to have to do is capture that 4-inch indicator and count the mystery clicks. Now I'm not going to count the threads on the side because that has a potential to be inaccurate. And so what I want to do is, because the tool is indexed in the groove of the thread, not the thread itself, not the exterior part of the thread. So whenever we have a measurement that lands in between a half-inch indicator, I always request that it's actually physically clicked and counted. So I'm going to capture the indicator, and I'm going to click it down, which is 1. One click. The measurement is 4 1/16. But in reality, this piece of wood actually falls between 4 inches in my 4-inch setup. In my 4-inch setup, my information rod is a little short. And in the 4 1/16 setup, my information rod is a little long. So the beauty of that is that I can tactily tell the difference between 4 1/16 and 4 inches. And what that means is that this measurement falls between 4 1/16 and 4, meaning I'm getting down to a 32nd of an inch accuracy. So this measurement is significantly closer to 4 1/32 of an inch wide.
And that's how blind people do STEM. For more information, visit blindscience.org.